We are going on a little treasure hunt today to ferret out a collection of San Francisco's secret gardens and oases. These are the perfect place to meet up with friends for a coffee and lunch, or just to hide away for a couple of minutes or a couple of hours and just have a little bit of peace and quiet. These are the little known San Francisco POPOS, or the privately owned public open spaces. The first POPOS was created in the 1960s by the developers of the landmark Transamerica building here, which is behind me. And after that, quite a few developers also used a similar strategy to try to get exceptions from the building commission on density and height restrictions. Over time, these POPOS became valuable to the residents of San Francisco as a way to maintain the character of the city, especially as it became encroached with these impersonal high-rises and large office buildings. So in 1985, the requirement to build POPOS was codified. So today, any new building or structure that goes up here in the city is required to have a POPOS with public art. There are currently over 70 POPOS, and they're all centered mainly around the financial district here, as well as down in SOMA, where the office building density is much higher. Today, we're gonna go check out some of the more popular and striking ones. Our first stop is the original POPOS, the Redwood Park at the Transamerica building. The Transamerica building was completed in 1972. The original POPOS was an observation deck on the 24th floor, but this was closed after 9/11 and the Redwood Park developed. The Redwoods are transplanted from Santa Cruz. At the center is a water fountain featuring Jumping Frogs by Mark Twain, who used to write from this site. There's also Children at Play by Glenna Goodacre, and a plaque honoring Bummer and Lazarus, two dogs owned by Emperor Norton, an eccentric San Francisco character from the 1800s who thought he was Emperor of the United States. Bordering Redwood Park is the indoor POPOS at 505 Sansom. The atrium windows look out on the redwoods, and it's a great alternative on a cold or rainy day. A bit further down the street is our next San Francisco POPOS at 343 Sansom. This is my pick for best rooftop POPOS. Just take the elevator up to the 15th floor. No need to check in with the front desk. The view and sun terrace here is spacious with an airy outdoor garden atmosphere. The center is Joan Brown's Four Seasons Sundial Obelisk statue, which provides a pop of color and whimsy. There's spacious seating for every need, intimate conversations or mealtime noshing. Shade is provided by native olive trees, and the views of the city are spectacular. There's a sliver of a view of the bay through these two buildings there. On this side of the rooftop, we've got a great view of the Transamerica building.
A close runner-up is the terrace at 1 Kearney near Union Square. Sign in and take the elevators to the 11th floor. It's small, but it's quiet and provides a more historical viewpoint. Around us are some really beautiful Art Deco buildings. Check out the Art Deco molding on this building in front of us. And the building behind is another classic example of Art Deco.
You also get this really lovely view on the architectural details of this building right next to us. We're heading now for SOMA, or South of Market.
The best modern indoor POPOS is at the new LinkedIn building at 222 2nd Street. This building was completed in March 2016, and the architecture was very controversial, with some calling it a black hole. The wall of glass doors lets in natural light. Inside is a bustling great room paneled in warm woods and modern touches. There are even Harry Bertoia chairs with its famous scooped-out design. A recent requirement, LinkedIn provides a cafe, restrooms, and Wi-Fi. abstract pieces from famed American artist Frank Stella grace the walls. The terrace seating is a great place to have lunch and watch LinkedIn business being conducted.
We're here at 555 Mission, and this is my pick for the POPOS with the best public art.
This outdoor plaza fronting the building is called the Garden of Light. In the center is Jonathan Baranski's Human Structures art installation, a stacked tower of 62 brightly painted steel figures. Like the statues on Easter Island, Moonrise by Swiss artist Ugo Rondinone presides over the plaza with its funky trio of giant heads. The building itself was the first LEED Gold certified office building in the city, including the eco-friendly POPOS.
All the garden elements, including this living wall of plant, adds to the building's LEED certification. These are ginkgo trees. We're at the POPOS here at 1 San Som, and for me, this is my pick for the most magnificent classical architecture.
This structure was originally the Anglo and London Paris National Bank, completed in 1910. Citibank purchased the building and converted it into a covered atrium. It's currently being renovated, so it's a bit messy. It's got towering entryways and a glassed-in roof. This is the original white marble with black detailing.
There's a little crepe stand here if you want to get dessert. This is the newer Citigroup Center Tower, and it's built right adjacent to the POPOS. This was completed in 1984, and it has the Montgomery Street BART station in the basement. That was just a small sample of some of the fantastic public spaces that are available to us here in San Francisco. If you'd like to explore more, I'm going to include a link down in the description box below with a map to all of the 70 POPOSes here in San Francisco. Till next time, peace out, Geeksters.